when the frost had killed the daisies and the hills were white with snow, Robert Burns was born in Ayrshire just 100 years ago. Cold about the cottage ingle, when the cloudy night fell down, blew the wind from off the moorlands, where the heath was crisp and brown. But the boy was summer's darling, made of music, love, and fire, and though winter could not harm him, let it wreck its utmost ire. Now 100 years are numbered, yet we hail the happy morn, when amid the Ayrshire snow wreaths, Robert Burns, the man, was born. With his head upon her bosom, in the firelight's ruddy glow, plaintive songs his mother sang him, heirs of Scotland long ago. And he thrilled at tales of heroes, or of ghosts and warlocks grim, till he felt a chilly horror creeping over every limb, as he shuddered as the tempest shook the window in its moan, lest the sobbing and the sighing were a murdered victim's groan. Now his name is linked with story, now his life is set to song, all that Scotland has of glory floats with Robert Burns along. So the boy grew older, loving every wild and winsome thing, from the rush of stormy waters to the lark upon the wing. He, a lark too, warbling upward from the heather's purple guise, finding sweetest inspiration in the light of women's eyes. Dante shrined his Beatrice, Laura lives in Petrarch's rhyme. Tenderer praise have Scottish maidens down through all the coming time. Every woman loves the singer, from the peasant to the queen, for the sake of Heland Mary, for the sake of Bonnie Jean. How he longed for better knowledge, how he yearned for noble fame, he the plowman, the unlettered, born to bear a humble name. Oh, my poet, thou didst cast it in the furrow of the years, that as a man, for all that, thou didst water it with tears. Now the harvest time is coming, now the fields are white with grain. Thou, the sower, art the reaper, binding sheaves on every plain. Ah, the human soul is deeper than the lore he never knew, so the lays he sung shall echo all the listening ages through. Tell us not of mighty princes rolling proud or shores near. Robert Burns has kingdom grander than the stateliest of these. Theirs by mountain chains is bounded on a river's winding line. His sweeps broad from tropic palm trees to the forest polar pine. Scotland, as a gem, she wears it, dowered with song his lowly birth, and at last his meed immortal is the homage of the earth. Pardon sins he sorrowed over. He who light on daisies trod, say he was of man the lover. Leave to him the love of God. Slow but surely comes the morning. Lo, the east is flushed with rose, and the wind so chill at dawning with the warmer current blows. Truth at last shall be the victor, bearing freedom in its van, while the watchword on its banner is the brotherhood of man. Thrones and crowns and jeweled scepters like forgotten toys will be. Only he who loves his fellows shall the heights of others see. Then, recounting lives of heroes as their memory backward turns, truest prophet, sweetest singer, men shall reckon Robert Burns.
Hello, Hopkinton.
Hello.
There you go. Being as this is my first time at the Hopkinton Open Mic, allow me to introduce myself. My name is Ed Bannett, and I'm a walking minstrel. I like to make people laugh, so I go around telling stories, reciting poetry, telling jokes. I can even entertain you on the piano, and I've been known to sing a song or two. My only compensation is if I can put a smile on your face, a song in your heart, and a spring in your step. Today, I'd like to entertain you with a poem that I wrote over 52 years ago to my beloved wife, Claire, now recently deceased. It's a love poem, sort of like a Valentine, but I don't think I gave it to her on Valentine's Day. The main thing about this poem is that it expresses my love for my wife so perfectly that I hope you'll forgive me if I get emotional when I read it to you. The name of this poem is My Thoughts. Now, my thoughts could very well be your thoughts. So as I recite this poem, I would like you to think of somebody that you love very much. Could be a spouse, a significant other, a son or a daughter, a sister or brother, a parent, grandparent, an uncle or an aunt, or even a close friend. It could even be someone who has recently passed away whom you missed tremendously. My thoughts. My thoughts go out like messengers, swiftly on their way, bearing precious gifts to you each moment of the day. Ceaselessly I send them forth. Untiringly they bring the love that pours forth from my heart in a never-ending spring. With trumpets to precede them and songs of joy and gladness, they enter in and bring the word. 'Twill be an end to sadness. For though distance is between us and miles keep us apart, no space could e'er exceed the love that occupies my heart. So receive these thoughts with gladness. May they fill your days with pleasure. For the joy you've given me, my love, exceeds all boundless measure. Thank you very much.
I wanted to read a poem today by Denise Levertov from her book Breathing the Water that she wrote in 1987. And it's called Making Peace. I gotta calm down. Day two, I gotta calm down. Making Peace. A voice from the dark called out, "The poets must give us imagination of peace to oust the intense familiar imagination of disaster. Peace, not only the absence of war, but peace, like a poem, is not there ahead of itself, can't be imagined before it is made, can't be known except in the words of its making, grammar of justice, syntax of mutual aid, a feeling towards it dimly sensing a rhythm is all we have until we begin to utter its metaphors, learning them as we speak. A line of peace might appear if we restructured the sentence of our lives are making, revoked its reaffirmation of profit and power, questioned our needs, allowed long pauses. A cadence of peace might balance its weight on that different fulcrum, peace, a presence, an energy field more intense than war might pulse then, stanza by stanza, into the world, each act of living, one of its words, each word a vibration of light, facets of the forming crystal. Thank you.
It began as faith, and one as family would. Begone, not ever, for each, unafraid. Yet all lost before known without eyes. To see the longings, felt unknown, felt unafraid still. Not known ever by six wandering ones, too. And remorse of what is told is remorse of feelings never learned. By encompassing embrace, unrelenting, unfelt, as life may often be. 8 was the illume one evening, above furrowed brow. 8 crescent moons dug deep, inverted red, solemn brows, eyelids lashless. I sat, middle of 5, quiet, knowing this evening's roster, 7, intact as known, yet the most heavy of plates drops. Everything quivers and flips, restored on time by fused impacts as life reigns behind yet one more closed door. There had to be a calling. There had to be a light. There had to be life somewhere outside. Quietly, 7 became 6. Dinner overmade. Thanks.
Mama said you think you're something special. With your big dreams leaving us behind, can't you see you're going nowhere? Just like me, just like me. She had a chance to be a singer as a young girl. They said her gifts would take her far. Then her daddy left, took her dreams with him. Grandma made her come back home. She said,
big dreams born here, big dreams die here.
Don't be a fool and hope like me. My bitter tears cried for wasted years. Wait and see, wait and see, you're just like me. And oh, she had such big dreams, a voice as sweet and strong, and made to be heard. And oh, I feel her bitter tears for a life that should have been, but never was. And her big dreams. Mama, I know the hurt you've held for so long. Worn down in this town, But you know I'm bound for something better. Mama just need to prove it to you. She said, big dreams born here, big dreams die here. Don't be a fool and hope like me. My bitter tears cried for wasted years. Wait and see, you wait and see. I said, big dreams born here, don't have to die here. Maybe there's still hope for me, yeah. Bitter tears cried for wasted years. Wait and see, wait and see, wait and see.
So this poem is a September 11th poem. After it happened, we all joined hands in a church. Different races, different faiths, singing loud, we shall overcome someday. In back rooms and in dark caves, plans were already being made to drown our music out with one single relentless note, the beating of the drums. That's it. Thank you.
And in keeping with the theme today in ciphering, I think John just had to leave, but ciphering to his poem about truth, I'll read a poem I wish I hadn't written. The background is I spent my summer vacations in Louisiana at one of the small family farms. Never thought about where one of them came from. At the age of 21, my grandmother brought out a ledger about this big of early farm records. It showed that, I don't know if the economy had gone, their economy had gone bad or what, but it said we sold one slave to a neighbor and his wife to another neighbor. I hope it was all benign, but we don't know. That was when I was 21, and I was introducing my soon-to-be fiancée to my grandmother. 40 years later, I had never spoken about it with her or with the kids we produced or any family members. And I called my mother one day, and this is in my hometown in Texas, and she says she's having a medical procedure. And I said, who's taking you? And she said, Angela. From that sprung out this verse I called Angelina. I said, wasn't Angelina your mom's maid? And she said, yes, Angelina was my mom's maid. So I wrote Angelina in about 5 minutes. One of my poet friends told me, no, I wrote it in 40 years. Grandma had a maid named Angelina. She was the best friend I ever had. She would listen to my troubles, cheer me up when I was sad. Told me about her ancestor, sailed the ocean on some boat, locked in chains with other captives, miracle that it would float. Sold to some big cotton farmer, 30 lashes when he tried, running off to somewhere better, looking for his child and bride. Angelina, Angelina, please forgive our family for not realizing y'all were just as good as we. Your scattered kin, your bending backs, your longing to be free. Angelina, Angelina, please forgive our family. Your will to live and strength to toil through steamy nights and days on foreign soil with foreign tongues and harsh plantation ways. We thought that you were ignorant and not as wise as we. Angelina, Angelina, please forgive our family. And when I listened to her tales, I couldn't understand how we might not have been here but for strong and gentle hands, worked our fields and made them fertile, nursed our babies at their breast. But when we prayed in church, we didn't know how we'd been blessed. Lands we owned for generations might lie fallow, parched, and dry, and families proud and prosperous might wither, fail, and die. But for your perseverance and your willing to survive, while others watch their fortunes rise and sons and daughters thrive, that we might gather more and write our names in history. Angelina, Angelina, please forgive our family. Thank you.
Darkest days of winter, at the waning of the year, in the stillness of the cold, comes a message soft but clear. Not a gathering of angels or a bugle's brazen blare, but a whisper in the stillness, a glimmer in the drear, a promise for tomorrow. The sun will reappear, a promise for tomorrow. The sun will reappear. Though you might miss the signal of the lifting of the dark, a baby's laugh, a tender touch, a meeting in the park. The lighting of the darkness is the lifting of a stone, a message in the morning. We do not walk alone. We do not walk alone. When hazy days of grayness feel like cotton to the soul, when life's constant disappointments make a mockery of toil, though days stretch on forever and nights are longer still, and the tunnel's twists and turnings seem an endless path until there comes a morning sunrise to free the light and will. There comes a morning sunrise to free the light and will. Though you might miss the signal of the lifting of the dark, a baby's laugh, a tender touch, a meeting in the park. The lighting of the darkness is the lifting of a stone, a message in the morning. We do not walk alone. We do not walk alone. The fight against injustice wears your spirit down. If you know your destination, but a path cannot be found, standing by the barricades, take a look around at the crowd of kindred spirits who stand on common ground. Voices raised together in a rare and holy sound. Voices raised together in a rare and holy sound. though you might miss the signal of the lifting of the dark. A baby's laugh, a tender touch, a meeting in the park. The lighting of the darkness is the lifting of a stone. A message in the morning. We do not walk alone. There's a message in the morning. We do not walk alone. We do not walk alone. Thank you.
Just a minute, folks.
It's Divin' Drivin' time, and we got a great Western for you today.
Divin' Drivin' is a new program featuring the HCAM staff's favorite B-movies. We hope you'll enjoy these treasured films of yesteryear.
And even if we don't get paid, there ain't no job we trade. We're hauling freight and stages ain't no longer set of pay.
So check out the HCAM TV website at hcam.tv for movie days and showtimes.
Hi, welcome to Break Gardens.
Just make sure that you water regularly and through November.
So I think we can go ahead and start backfilling here.
I think fall is one of the best times to plant roses.
When you can squeeze your soil and hold it together, that's good.